admire for so many things that you do. I agree with so many things that you do. How long have you had the piece? Those are my favorite kinds of pieces, actually. Pieces that I learned from a while back and then come back to it, either to renew it or to continue on with it. Somehow I always feel like it's more subtle in my hands when it's had that kind of path. Very nice work. I would say the thing that I'm missing the most is some kind of energy, tension, some kind of fear, some kind of stronger emotion. Right now, it feels, if I were going to put a word into it, I would say that it was regal. There's this a bearing about it that's quite strong in a way, and it's good. It's a sense of pride. I want it to be more tense. It just feels a little bit too comfortable for me. So, living on the edge a little bit. I think the tempo is a little bit too slow. I think that it should be faster. I think there are moments where you actually just slow down and then you pick up some other places. Not too much, but overall I think it could be faster. And then in places where it's softer, that's actually the most tension as far as I'm concerned. And it almost just felt very always relaxed. I want to feel the sense of motion, propulsion. Everybody knows that the last movement is a perpetual motion, right, to this amount. This first movement is also perpetual, always, all the way through. Sometimes it's just the triplets of the eight, sometimes it's the 16s, but that is never far, far away. Even when you have long notes inside, the triplet is always going. So there is a perpetual motion in here. If you can keep that going, then I think we'll have a little bit more success in terms of getting that excitement. Now, a lot of things create excitement. Movement creates excitement, so that's why I'm going to ask you to move a little bit faster in some of the tempos. The contrast of dynamics, the extremes, from fortissimo to pianissimo, or forte to piano, and being right on a dime, the cleanest, sharpest changes possible, and then that sometimes has to do with pedal, how much you're using, the releases of it, as well as just in your hands and the keys. So those kinds of things. Right away at the very beginning, your voicing is so beautiful, it's always in the top of your right hand. In this particular case, I prefer a mixed voicing. So I don't actually want to hear so much of your right hand. The reason why I want to hear the mixed is I actually want to hear the hollowness of the distance between the two hands. You know, he could have written it an octave apart, but he writes two octaves. He wants the hollowness. And if you only bring out the top as you did, then I lose a sense of the missing inside. I hear a matter of interpretation. But for me, it's just a swell, just a little swell. Your crescendos are a little bit too obvious for me. Yeah, do the second one. Sometimes in your own ear, you have to be careful not to play too many or too little because you want to be feeling 2-1, 2-1, 2-1, 2-1, 2-1. So you can change that later on or think about doing it that way. But all the way through with these repeated notes, I will try using that fingering. But that's the idea, is the fingering will facilitate the character that you're looking for, which is this pedal on E flat. That's a pedal, right? And so we want to be able to hear that E flat. relative marking, it depends on where it comes from. All of this is coming from a piano, and then it says frottando piano. So to me, that frottando is not that big. It's not that big. What is the purpose of these frottando pianos?
Just to be some kind of scary
character. Yeah, scary character is good. He writes it here, he writes it there, and then it's kind of the same thing here. If you think about it, all of those are the Neapolitan relations. Yeah? So that's all he wants. It's just he did it. So when we hear this, it's just hearing the Neapolitan, that's all. It's not just an accent to be scary, but finding that Neapolitan one more time. Can we try from here? Or the measure before? Just remember this is only one and four. Yeah, that's it.